The Shergarh Conspiracy. The kidnapping of champion racehorse Shergarh remains one of Britain's most baffling whodunits. For two decades, the disappearance of the celebrated Derby winner has been shrouded in a fog of mystery and conspiracy theories. His debut race in 1981 was the Guardian Classic Trial at Sandown Park. On Tuesday, the 8th of February 1983, a foggy winter's evening in Ireland, a group of men wearing balaclavas and armed with guns turned up at the Ballymeny Stud Farm in County Kildare. It was a visit that would go down in horse racing history. With one hostage already taken, Jim Fitzgerald, the stud's head groom, the men had come to take another. "We've come for Shergarh," they said. Shergarh was arguably the greatest racehorse to have ever lived. But 25 years after he was kidnapped from Ballymeny, the mystery of exactly what happened to him after he was snatched that night still lingers. Then, as now, the story was one that gripped the world. From racing enthusiasts to ordinary members of the public, everyone wanted to know who had taken Shergarh, why they had done so, and what became of him. And then, as now, no definite answers were forthcoming. The theories are numerous, with the IRA, Colonel Gaddafi, and the Mafia featuring among the most lurid. One story suggests that the IRA kidnapped the horse for Gaddafi in return for weapons. Gaddafi's motive for wanting the horse was said to stem from his belief that he should lead the Islamic people rather than the direct descendants of the Prophet Muhammad, such as the Aga Khan, one of Shergarh's owners. Another theory is that the New Orleans Mafia took Shergarh. Frenchman Jean-Michel Gambert, so the tale went, borrowed money from the Mafia to buy a horse from the Aga Khan. The deal collapsed and Gambert apparently spent the money. Gambert was found dead in a car in Kentucky, but the Mafia felt they were still owed a horse from the Aga Khan and took Shergarh. However, the most probable and likely version of events is that Shergarh was taken by the Provisional IRA, who demanded a multi-million pound ransom from the owners to fund purchases of weapons so it could continue its fight against the British presence in Northern Ireland. On the racetrack, Shergarh's racing career was short but incredibly successful. The bay colt, with the distinctive white blaze on his nose, raced just 8 times in a year, winning 6 times and banking nearly £500,000 in prize money before he was retired to stud in October 1981. Undoubtedly, his most famous victory came in the Epsom Derby in 1981. Ridden by the 19-year-old jockey Walter Swinburne, Shergarh started as favorite and obliterated the field, winning by 10 lengths, the biggest victory margin in the race's 226-year history. It secured the horse's place in sporting immortality and in the hearts of the nation. However, everything changed on that Tuesday in 1983. Shortly after 8:30 p.m., Jim Fitzgerald heard a knock at his door. When his son, Bernard, answered it, he was confronted by the three men. At gunpoint, Mr. Fitzgerald, then 53, was forced to take the three men and the rest of their gang to Shergarh's stable and help them load the horse into a horse box they had brought with them. After that, he was driven away from the stud and thrown out of the car with instructions for representatives of the Aga Khan as to how they could negotiate with the kidnappers. After his release, Mr. Fitzgerald phoned the stud manager, Ghislaine Dryan. Mr. Dryan phoned Shergarh's vet, Stan Cosgrove, who had also bought a share in the horse. Mr. Cosgrove, in turn, called his friend, the former army officer Captain Sean Berry, who rang Alan Dukes, the local MP who was also the Irish finance minister. Amazingly, it was more than 4 hours before the Irish police were alerted and the police investigation into one of sport's greatest whodunits began. But, from both the kidnappers' and the Garda's point of view, the Shergarh episode was fraught with serious problems from the outset. The first problem for the police was the kidnapping's timing. Shergarh was taken the day before Ireland's biggest racehorse sale, a day on which horse boxes were driven on roads across the country, making an impossible task to find the box containing Shergarh. The investigation was further complicated because officers from both Dublin and County Kildare were put on the case. The two forces reportedly refused to share information and believed that they were in direct competition with each other. However, one common factor in most of the conspiracy theories was the probable involvement of the Provisional IRA. This view was given greater weight in the 1990s when the IRA member turned informer Sean O'Callaghan alleged that the paramilitary group was behind the kidnapping. The IRA, in desperate need of money to buy weapons, had previously kidnapped rich businessmen to raise ransom money. However, the sight of the kidnapped victims' families and loved ones crying on television was thought to be costing them support in their Republican heartlands. This, according to O'Callaghan, gave rise to the plot to kidnap Shergar. But, in the first of a series of blunders, the IRA underestimated the outrage that such an act would spark in a country with such a strong love of horses. The most often repeated stories surrounding Shergar's death, while never proven, seem to have been gradually accepted in Ireland as the truth. But even today, 25 years after his disappearance, little is known of Shergar's final resting place. He is rumored to be buried 100 miles from the Ballymeny stud in a mountainside grave in Ballinamore, County Leitrim, but the failure to find his body means that one thing is certain: after a murder mystery that has lasted more than quarter of a century and cost Ireland one of sport's greatest animals, there were no winners in this sad tale. The IRA never got the ransom money it demanded. Horse racing was robbed of potentially one of its greatest studs, and the horse's owners did not receive a penny from Shergar's life insurance policy because a body was never found. And, while the theories and debate about Shergar's disappearance will probably rage for another 25 years, Walter Swinburne says he is resigned to the fact that he will never truly know what happened to the horse he described as the greatest he has ever ridden. "It's been 25 years now and I must have heard a million and one theories about what happened to him,"